My blissful gorgeous self, Sri Krishna of Vrindavan, is going back and forth waiting for you to receive his blessings. With all the malabhishekh avaran, hallucinatory obsessions are mati brahma, drishti brahma and rajalik, or vibhrahma or mohamaya. Whatever is the reason, our intense negativity and blockages of worldly ignorance in engagement and busyness, his blessing is not being able to get through to you. So get it through Bhagavad Katha before too late, before it is no longer available. Listen to Bhagavad Katha with Sri Krishna's ambrosial embrace commentary, and things will start settling up for you spiritually and materially, both 200%, my dear friends. Varhapidam natavaravapuho karnayo karnikaram bibhradvasa kanaka kapisham vajayantin shamalam randhran venu radharadudaya purayan gopavrindai vrindaranyam swapadaramanam pra My blissful gorgeous self, Yasha Tatri Yashodama, remember, Vedanta says, if you listen the glories of nature of your true self, you realize. Bhakti Yoga says, if you listen the Yasha and Kirti of the dancing God, you realize. Sravanam Ketanam Vishnu Smaranam Padasevanam. Now gopis are seeing vast expanse of Vrindavan. Snow white beautiful cows are moving, following them that golden silk wearing one. Following them the wild flower garland wearing one. Peacock feather crowned one is moving by the gate of dance, in tune with music which he himself is producing on his flute. The flute is the same Vag Devi, my dear friends. Sometimes he smiles, then he looks with sidelong lenses, then arching eyebrow, then his crown dazzles out, then his dress shines out, then his bright earring reflects out on his cheeks. Gopas are singing songs of his beauty and grace and multidimensional wonder, my dear friend. Because of thousand years of mlecha government, mlecha dictator, mlecha rules, and 70 years of Congolese secularistic rule, and 9 years of secular Abbasi Hindu Modi rules, our culture has become a big mess. There is no such thing as casteism, but four varnas, Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Shudra, intellectual, warrior, and merchant, and labor classes. It was division of labor DNA base to develop hereditary skillness, but Christian foreign rulers named it casteism, And the same wrong perspective is being dragged by Congress and BJP and 22 parties, evil parties which are working all parts of India. They are misleading people with this wrong interpretation of Varnashram Dharma, calling it casteism. In the same way, there was division of developing level of consciousness called Brahmacharya Grihasthavan plus Sannyas. That means if you stay preserving your semen for 25 years and studying the Vedas and preserving your semen for 25 years, and next 25 years for family, next 25 years for educating the society, and then you will always be healthy and mentally and highly mature. And then in last 25 years you become enlightened, completely blissed out in yourself, my dear friends. That was the custom, that was the system, that was the reason why this nation was blessed and known as Bharatvarsh. Okay. So, my dear friends, there is only one spot worthy to surrender. In fourth ashram, all people, all kings take refuge. When the fire of Jnana and Vairagya burn out with expected speed, all gentlemen take refuge there, which is known as Aranya, the forest. Vrindaranya Padaramanam Vrindaranyam Swapadaramanam Vrindaranyam Swapadaramanam. Among all these worthy forest, Vrindavan is the supreme. Because Swapadaramanam is the supreme, because Swapadaramanam, it is abounding with footprints of Bhagavan Sri Krishna. Swapadai Ankitai Ramanam, every nook and corner of Vrindavan have Bhagavan Sri Krishna's footprints. Each dust particle has its footprints. Okay? Sri Krishna's beauty is in the beauty of all illustrious footprints, my dear friends. Our friend Baba Pulin Bihari Das is getting upset. He says, only Sri Krishna's footprints, what about Sri Radha's footprints? Of course, yes. Yes, swasya Sri Radhaya Ankitai Padai Ramanam. Sri Krishna goes there and Sri Radha goes there picking up flowers with her friends. Sometime in the night to enjoy moonshine, other time to Yamuna Beach. Everywhere are the footprints of Sri Radha and Sri Krishna both. In such an woodland of bliss and beauty, Pravishajita Kirti Samantat Avishat. Krishna entered from all sides and lo, in the vast lake of Vrindavan, Krishna with his gopa friends dancing around. leaping and jumping and dancing around. Iti venuravam rajan sarvabhuta manoharam shrutva vrajastriya sarva varnayantyo vire vire. Where words do not provide vision with the meaning, it becomes useless. Here is unique example of words power, my dear friend. The gopal, the gopis began to see exactly what they described. The perfume of their love rose permeating everywhere. Flowers of love bloomed, honey of love began to drip from trees. All beings are captivated and began to look at Bhagavan Sri Krishna, and he gazed at Gopal's heart. Gopis began to describe sights and visions and events more picturesquely as they went on describing. So they began seeing and embracing Krishna again and again and again. My dear friends, now the gopi said, deep blue water-filled lakes and ponds with blossoming pink lotus flowers of autumn season with their perfume has been inviting Krishna to come and play his flute near them. And groups of snow-white swans are sporting and gliding in and around the lakes and cooing herons, echoing the Mahavakyas of the Vedas. What are the Mahavakyas, my dear friends? The same Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma, Prajnanam Brahma, or Aham Brahmasmi Tattvamasi. So these are echoing and re-echoing, resembling liberated souls swimming in the sea of spiritual bliss. Splendid fragrance is spreading all over as it perfumes of flute. Playing Krishna, arrival is announced everywhere, floating. White clouds in the sky resemble the white clothes in light, and the yogis have hanged and spread out to dry after they have taken their bath in Akashaganga river. Reflections of these white clouds in the water of lakes and ponds and Yamuna river water appear as new. Many camphor beaches are formatted for possible Rasa Leela dance tonight here. Okay? My dear friends, now the first group of gopis saw. Who were they, my dear friends? They were Sruti Rupa gopis. They are the ones in the presiding deities of Hemans of the Vedas, Vagdevi gopis. So Vagdevi gopis sang aloud, Akshanvatam Paramidam Naparam Vidamaha. Akshanvatam Paramidam Naparam Vidamaha. Sakya Pashunar Viveshaya Turmayas Jai. Vakra Rajaya Lunayo. Love it always indescribable, my dear friends. The way of love is always inconceivable. Those who say, I love you, or I am in love with you, do not even know what love is. They say, I have fallen in love with you, negative love with you, I have fallen in. They don't even know what love is. Love resides right in our heart. Appearance of beloved helps us to abide in love, feel the joy of it. His love and our love for each other is seen personally. Krishna's transcendental form is the very success, the very fruit of having eyes. Okay? Embodiment of that divine love is Krishna. Therefore, seeing Krishna is the very success, the very fruit of having eyes. Okay? Otherwise, it is better to stay blind. So, the only success of having eyes is to perform your duties and responsibilities, to clean up your heart and walk on the path of Dharma, have a high character, so your heart will be cleansed and then your perspective will be set rightly and then you can live according to Dharma and then you become enlightened. So, through meditation and knowledge, there won't be the real fruit, the peak success of having eyes. Through meditation, only distraction could be eliminated. And through Vedantic analysis, only misunderstanding or misidentification could be dispelled. Nowadays, the fruits are enlarged, more tasty and beautified. What about this life's fruit? This life's fruit. There are four kinds of fruits of life. Many consider having enormous wealth. Becoming billionaire, trillionaire is the fruit of life. That is the only fruit. Others say having loving friends in all countries, marrying with Miss Universes in every country of all races, and enjoying delicious dishes of each culture in each country, shopping in the World Trade Centers in all countries are the fruit, the success of life. Others say earning great religious meritorious deeds, to have palatial mansion in the heaven lasting for millions of years in paradise is the real fruit of life. And becoming king of paradise, becoming king of astral world, like Indra, is the great fruit. Others say becoming cosmic conscious, being jivan mukta, attaining nirvana, attaining moksha is the real fruit of life. Then life is successful. But gopis are unique. Gopis say all these former fruits could also be evolved and made more tasteful, sweet, and far more bigger, more important. That fruit is born nourished by Yashodama and relished by